بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد بإذن الله today we're going to start the book الشر القواعد الأربع the explanation of the four principles and this is another treatise by Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdul Wahab رحمه الله and it will be explained by Sheikh Saleh Al Fawzan بإذن الله تعالى so I'm going to go and begin with this بإذن الله تعالى so Bismillah. So we begin here. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى. The author he said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. أسأل الله الكريم رب العرش العظيم أن يتولاك في الدنيا والآخرة وأن يجعلك مباركا أينما كنت وأن يجعلك ممن إذا أؤتي شكر وإذا ابتلي صبر وإذا أذنب استغفر فإن هؤلاء الثلاث عنوان السعادة. So the Sheikh he begins with saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, I ask Allah, yeah, the generous, the Lord of the tremendous throne, that he take care of you and guard you in the dunya. In this life and in the akhirah, and that he make you blessed wherever you be, may be, and that he make you from those, if they are given, are grateful, and if they are tested, they are patient, and if they are sin, they seek forgiveness, because in these three traits is the epitome of happiness. So then the Sheikh Saleh Fawzan is going to explain this. He says, هذه القواعد الأربعة التي ألفها شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله هو وهي رسالة مستقلة ولكنها تطبع مع ثلاثة الأصول من أجل الحاجة إليها لتكون في متناول أيدي طلبة العلم والقواعد جمع قاعدة والقاعدة هي الأصل الذي يتفرع عنه مسائل كثيرة أو فروع كثيرة ومضمون هذه القواعد الأربعة التي ذكرها الشيخ رحمه الله معرفة التوحيد ومعرفة الشرك. So the Sheikh he mentions Sheikh Saleh Fawzan حفظه الله he explains these four principles قواعد الأربعة which the Sheikh has authored, Sheikh Islam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab, may Allah have mercy upon him. This is a treatise that is independent, but it was printed with the Thalathat al-Uthul. And that's the three fundamental principles that our brother Shaib is going through. So he's printed with that because of the need of it and that it be in easy reach for the students of knowledge. And the والقواعد قواعد الأربعة we say is a plural of قاعدة means principle so it means the four principles والقاعدة here and the قاعدة the principle it means the foundation which you know split off or branched off from it many issues or you know many branches. And then the Sheikh, he mentions that, and what is, these four principles, they contain within them, that the Sheikh mentioned, may Allah have mercy on him, the knowledge of knowing Tawheed, and of shirk. So yeah, the knowledge of tawheed and shirk. So then the Sheikh he says, وَمَا هِيَ الْقَاعِدَ فِي التَّوْحِيدِ And what is the principle in tawheed? وَمَا هِيَ الْقَاعِدَ فِي الشِّرْكِ And what is the principle in shirk? لِأَنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ يَتَخَبَّتُونَ فِي حَذَيْنَ الْأَمْرَيْنِ يَتَخَبَّتُونَ فِي مَعْنَى التَّوْحِيدُ مَا هُوَ وَيَتَخَبَّتُونَ فِي مَعْنَى الشِّرْكِ كل يفسرهما على حسب هواه So then the Sheikh, he says that what is the principle in Tawheed, or what is the principle in Shirk? Because many people, they struggle with these two affairs. They struggle in the meaning of Tawheed, what is it? And then they struggle in the meaning of Shirk. All of them explain them according to their desires. ولكن الواجب أننا نرجع في تعقيدنا إلى كتاب إلى الكتاب والسنة ليكون هذا التعقيد هذا التقييد تقييدا صحيحا سليما مأخوذ من كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا سيما في هذين الأمرين العظيمين التوحيد والشرك والشيخ رحمه الله لم يذكر هذه القواعد من عنده أو من فكره كما يفعل ذلك كثير من المتخبطين وإنما أخذ هذه القواعد من كتاب الله ومن سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسيرته. Then the Sheikh, he says, but it is wajib that we return in our deriving of the principles to the kitab, which is the Quran and the Sunnah, so that these deriving of principles is correct and sound from and taken from the Book of Allah and from the Sunnah of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, especially in these great affairs, these two great affairs, which is Tawheed and Shirk. So the Shaykh, may Allah mercy upon him, he did not mention these principles from himself, rather, or from his, you know, his ideas, or as many people do, from the people who struggle and stumble, they take, rather, this was taken, the principles were taken from the Kitab Allah, from the Book of Allah, the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and his seerah, and his life. Yeah. So this is where these four principles were taken. فَإِذَا عَرَفْتَ هَذِهِ الْقُوَاعِدِ وَفَهِمْتَهَا سَحُلَ عَلَيْكَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ مَعْرِفَةَ التُّوحِيدَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ اللَّهُ بِهِ رُسُلَهُ وَأَنْزَلَ بِهِ كُتُبَهُ وَمَعْرِفَةُ الشِّرْكِ الَّذِي حَذَّرَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ وَبَيَّنَ خَطَرَهُ وَضَرَرَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَهَذَا أَمْرٌ مُحِمٌّ جِدًّا وَهُوَ أَلْزَمَ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ مَعْرِفَةِ أَحْكَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ وَالْعِبَادَاتِ وَسَائِرِ الْأُمُورِ الدِّينِيَّةِ لِأَنَّ هَذَا هُوَ الْأَمْرُ الْأَوَّلِ وَالْأَسَاسِ لِأَنَّ الصَّلَاةَ وَالزَّكَاةَ وَالْحَجَّ وَغَيْرِهَا مِنَ الْعِبَادَاتِ لَا تَصِحُّ إِذَا لَمْ تبنى على أصل العقيدة الصحيحة وهي التوحيد الخالص لله عز وجل. So then the Sheikh says, if you know these principles and you understood them, then it becomes easy for you after that to know Tawheed, which Allah sent His messengers and He revealed His books you will also know the understand shirk, which Allah warned against, and which He clarified its danger and its harms in this life and the hereafter. So this affair is very important, and is more needed, more important upon you than knowing about the rulings of Salah, and the of zakat, of charity, of worship, of the on the remaining of the affairs that are religious affairs, because this is the first affair and the foundational issue, because salah and zakat and hajj and all other than that from the worships, they are not correct if they are not built upon a foundation and aqeedah sahiha, a correct aqeedah, and that is tawheed, sincerely for Allah alone. So worship Allah alone with sincerity. So then the Shaykh said, وَقَدْ قَدَّمَ رَحْمَ اللَّهُ لِهَذِهِ قَوَائِدْ أَرْبَعَ مقدم بمقدمة عظيمة فيها الدعاء لطلبة العلم وتنبيه على ما سيقوله، حيث قال: أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش الكريم أن يتولاك في الدنيا والآخرة، وأن يجعلك مباركا أينما كنت، وأن يجعلك ممن إذا أوتي شكر وإذا ابتلي صبر وإذا أذنب استغفر، فإن هذه الثلاث هي عنوان السعادة. So then the Shaykh, he said, indeed, the Shaykh has presented, may Allah mercy upon him, Shaykh Mohammed bin Abdul Wahab, a great introduction for these four principles. In it, he has made the dua for the students of knowledge, and he has, you know, brought to attention so that they, you know, they alerted to what he will say. Whereby he makes that dua, he says, ask Allah the most, you know, the tremendous, Allah al Kareem. So he missed out Allah the most generous. So he said, Allah the tremendous, and he said, the Arsh al Kareem. So the mixed up here, it should be Asla Allah al Kareem. So ask Allah the generous, what is it on here? Ask Allah the generous Lord of the tremendous throne, that he take care of you and guide you in this dunya and in the hereafter, and that he make you blessed wherever you may be, and he make you from those, if they are given, they are grateful and thankful, and if they are trialed, they are patient, and if they are sinned, they seek forgiveness. Because in these three characteristics, and these three is the epitome of happiness. Then the Shaykh, he says, "Hadihi muqaddama azima." This introduction is a great introduction. Fiha du'a min al-Shaykh. This is a du'a from the Shaykh, rahmullah. لكل طالب العلم يتعلم أقيدته يريد بذلك الحق. For every student of knowledge that is learning his aqidah, so that he can know the truth. وَيُرِيدُ بِذَلِكَ تَجَنُّبُ الضَّلَالِ وَالشِّرْكِ. So, and he wants by way of that to stay away from misguidance and shirk. فَإِنَّهُ حَرِيٌّ بِأَنْ يَتَوَلَّاكَ. So that he is more, because he is deserving that Allah take care of and guard him in this life and the hereafter. وَإِذَا تَوَلَّاهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا سَبِيلَ إِلَى الْمَاكِرِهِ أَنْ تَصِلَ إِلَيْهِ لَا فِي دِينِهِ وَلَا فِي دُنْيَاهُ. قال تعالى: الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياؤهم طاغوت. فَإِذَا تَوَلَّاكَ اللَّهَ أَخْرَجَكَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ ظُلُمَاتِ الشِّرْكِ والكفر والشكوك والإلحاد إلى نور الإيمان والعلم النافع والعمل الصالح، ذلك بأن الله مولى الذين آمنوا وأن الكافرين لا مولى لهم. So then the Shaykh, he said, so that if Allah, so he mentions here, if Allah take cares of you, if Allah were to take care of you and guard you in the dunya and the akhirah, then there is no path for those who are, you know, cunning, you know, makir. So those who are, for example, how do you put that? Those cunning and crafting and trying to plot against you. There's no path for them to reach you, not in this, not in your religion, and not in your worldly life. As Allah mentions, Allahu wali alladhina, Allah says wali alladhina amanu. Allah says Allah wali alladhina amanu. So Allah is the wali, protector, guardian of those who believe. So he brings them out from darkness into light. But as for those who disbelieve, their awliya, supporters and helpers, are ta'gut, false deities. And they bring them out from light into darkness. Those are the dwellers of the fire, and they will abide therein forever. And that is Surah Al-Baqarah was 257. And then Allah said, so if Allah takes care of you and guards you, and He takes you out from the darkness of shirk and disbelief and doubt and, you know, in apostasy and to the light of iman and knowledge, so beneficial knowledge and righteous actions, then Allah mentions ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ, and we mentioned that just there, ذَلِكَ, let's get that out. That's another ayah. So Allah mentioned ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ, he said ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَى الَّذِينَ, is the مَوْلَى الَّذِينَ, yeah, there we go. That is because Allah is the master, lord, helper, protector of those who believe, and the disbelievers have no mawla, no lord, no master, no helper, no protector. So then the sheikh, he says, then he says that فَإِذَا تَوَلَّكَ اللَّهَ بِرِعَايَتِهِ وَبِتَوْفِيقِهِ وَحِدَايَتِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ فَإِنَّكَ تَسْعَدُ سَعَادَةَ لَا شَقَاءَ فِي لَا شَقَاءَ بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الدُّنْيَا يَتَوَلَّكَ بِالْحِدَايَةِ وَالتَّوْفِيقِ وَالسَّيْرِ عَلَى الْمَنْحَجِ السَّلِيمِ وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ يَتَوَلَّكَ بِعَيْنٍ يُدْخِلُكَ جَنَّتَهُ خَالِدًا مُخَلَّدًا فِيهَا لَا خَوْفٌ وَلَا مَرْضٌ ولا شقاء ولا كبر ولا لا مكاره هذه ولاية الله لعبده المؤمن في الدنيا والآخرة. So then the Shaykh, he said, so if Allah takes care of you and protects you with His protection and with giving you success and guidance in the dunya and in your hereafter, then indeed you are going to be happy with the happiness, and that you will not be miserable and you will not have no misery after that ever. In the dunya, Allah will take care of you and guard you with His guidance and with success and by making you thread upon the correct methodology that is correct, yeah? And in the akhirah, by taking care of you and guiding you, that by entering you into His Jannah, and that you will remain there forever, and there is no fear of, and there's no illness, and there's no misery, and there's no arrogance, and there's no makar, there's no plotting against you. This is the hadhi wilayat Allah, this is the protection of Allah, wilayat Allah for His slave, the believer, in the dunya and akhirah. So then he says, قَالَ وَأَنْ يَجْعَلَكَ مُبَارِكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ. So he's going back to the dua now, that He makes you blessed wherever you are, meaning, إِذَا جَعَلَكَ اللَّهُ مُبَارِكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ فَهَذَا هُوَ غَايَةُ مُطَالِبٍ. يَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ الْبَرَكَ فِي أُمْرِكَ وَيَجْعَلَ الْبَرَكَ فِي رِزْقِكَ وَيَجْعَلَكَ بَرَكَ فِي إِلْمِكَ وَيَجْعَلَكَ بَرَكَ فِي أَمَلِكَ وَيَجْعَلَ الْبَرَكَ فِي في ذريتك أينما كنت تصاحبك البركة أينما توجهت وهذا خير عظيم وفضل من الله سبحانه وتعالى. So then he said, the Sheikh, he said, so when he said, and Allah make you blessed wherever you may be, if Allah makes you blessed wherever you may be, that this is the the utmost of thing that or the goal that is sought, that Allah Allah places barakah in your life. He places barakah in your sustenance. He places barakah in your knowledge. He places barakah in your actions. Allah places barakah in your progeny. And wherever you be, the blessings accompany you. And whatever you face, they accompany you. And this is a great good, and is bounty from Allah. I mean, the Most High. And Allah, and then the Shaykh, he said, وَأَنْ يَجْعَلْكَ مِمَّنْ إِذَا أُطِيَ شَكْرًا. And so from the dua, he said, if Allah make you from those who, if they are given, they are grateful. So this is خلاف الذي إذا أطي كفر النعمة وبطرها. So then the Shaykh, he says this is opposition to the one who, if he is given, he denies or is ungrateful of the blessing. فَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ إِذَا أُعْتُوا النِّعْمَةَ كَفَرُوا وَأَنْكَرُوا. So he said, indeed, many people, when they are given from the blessings, they deny them and they are ungrateful. وَصَرَفُوهَا فِي غَيْرِ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. And they spend them, the blessings, or give them in other than the path of Allah, in the obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. So then, فَصَارَتْ سَبَبًا لِشِقَاوَتِهِمْ. So it becomes a cause for their misery. أَمَّا مَنْ يَشْكُرُ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَزِيدُ. So as for the one who is grateful when he is given from the blessings, then Allah increases him. Allah says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. So Allah mentions here in this ayah, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ, which basically means, let's get that here. So, and if, so, so he said, so that said, I remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you give thanks by accepting faith and worshiping the name of Allah, I will give you more of my blessings. But if you are thankless, disbelievers, verily my punishment is indeed severe. So that's the full ayah. So Allah Jalla wa Ala, he increases Yazid al-Shakirin min fadlihi wa ihsani. Allah Jalla wa Ala, he increases those who are grateful from his bounty and from his in his goodness. فَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ الْمَزِيدِ. So if you want more from the blessings, ni'm, فَشْكُرُ اللَّهِ, then thank Allah Azza wa Jal. وَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ زَوَالَ النِّعَمْ فَكْفُرْهَا. So if you want the blessings to come to be an end, then deny the blessings of Allah. قَالَ وَإِذَا ابْتُلِيَ صَبْرًا. So then he said, one of the dua, he said, well, that if you are tried, that you are patient. Allah Jalla wa Allah يُبْتَلِي الْعَبْد يُبْتَلِيهِمْ بِمَسَائِبْ وَيُبْتَلِيهِمْ بِالْمَكَارِئِ وَيُبْتَلِيهِمْ بِالْأَعْدَاءِ مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ فَيَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَى الصَّبْرِ وَعَدَمِ الْيَأْسِ وَعَدَمِ الْقُنُوطِ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَيُثْبِتُونَ عَلَى دِينِهِمْ وَلَا يَتَزَحْزَحُونَ مَعَ الْفِتَنِ أَوْ يَسْتَسْلِمُونَ لِلْفِتَنِ بَلْ يُثْبِتُونَ عَلَى دِينِهِمْ ويصبرون على ما يقاسون من الأتعاب في سبيلها بخلاف الذي إذا ابتلي جزع وتسخط وقنت من رحمة الله عز وجل فهذا يزاد ابتلاء إلى ابتلاء ومسائب إلى مسائب. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله إذا أحب قوما ابتلاهم فمن رضي فله الرضا وَمَنْ سَخَتَ فَعَلَيْهِ السَّخَتْ وَأَعْذَمُ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءِ ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَالِ فَالْأَمْثَالِ ابْتُلِيَ الرُّسُلِ وَابْتُلِيَ الصِّدِّيقُونَ وَابْتُلِيَ الشُّهَدَاءِ وَابْتُلِيَ عِبَادُ اللَّهِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَكِنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا أَمَّا الْمُنَافِقُ فَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ فِي مَا وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ يعني الطرف فإن أصابه خير اطمأن به وإن أصابته فتنة انقلب على وجهه خسر الدنيا والآخرة ذلك هو الخسران المبين الدنيا ليست دائما نعيما وترفا وملذات وسرور ونصرا. ليست دائما هكذا. الله يداولها بين العباد. الصحابة أفضل الأمة. ماذا جرى عليهم من الابتلاء والامتحان؟ قال تعالى وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس فليوطن العبد نفسه عن أنه إذا ابتلي فإن هذا ليس خاصا به، فهذا سبق الأولياء الله، فيوطن نفسه ويصبر وينتظر الفرج من الله تعالى والعاقبة للمتقين. Then the Sheikh mentions that in the dua, if you are a child, that you're patient, that Allah indeed He tried His slaves and He tried them with misfortunes, and He tried them with things that were detested, and He tried them with enemies from the disbelievers and from the hypocrites, and they needed to be patient and with the and not to be one who calls into despair from the mercy of Allah. So this is from the mercy of Allah. So he does not, the one who does not despair and from the mercy of Allah, and those who are firm in their religion, and they do not move around with the fitan from one place to another, and they do not surrender to the fitan. Rather, they are firm in their religion, and they are patient on what difficulties they come across, and from the hardships and the tiredness in their path, in opposition to those if they are tried, that they are worried, and they despair from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. So this is this will increase their in their being tested to another test, and from misfortune to another misfortune. Allah, as the Prophet said, indeed Allah, if he loves a people, he tries them. So whoever is pleased with him, then Allah is pleased with them. And whoever is angry, then Allah is angry with them. And the Prophet said in another hadith, the greatest of people who were tested were the prophets. Then those liked him. So testing is part of the religion, part of the believers, that they will be tested. They need to know that. So then the Shaykh, he said, the prophets and the were tested, and those who are the truthful ones, and those who are the martyrs, and those who from the worshippers of Allah, from the believers, all of them were tested, and all of them were patient. As for the hypocrites, then Allah said in regards to them, and that from the people are those who worship Allah upon the edge. Meaning, so let's just get the actual meaning, which is ومن الناس من يعبد الله. There is ومن الناس من يعبد الله على حرف. And among mankind is he who worships Allah as it were upon the edge, meaning in doubt. Yeah, طرف meaning on the edge. فإن أصابه خير اطمأن به وإن أصابته فتنة انقلب على وجهه على وجهه خسر الدنيا والآخرة ذلك هو الخسران المبين. So then he said, Allah means, if good befalls him, he is content with it. But if a trial befalls him, he turns back on his face. He reverts back to disbelief after embracing Islam. He loses both this world and the hereafter. That is the evident loss. So that's what. So the dunya is not always some pleasant and happy and enjoyment and with success, and it's not always like that. So it's not a place that you're gonna find all this happiness and joy. Yeah. Rather, you're gonna come across tests. So yeah, you're gonna come across stress, hardship. You're gonna have to be patient. So this is the dunya. Yeah. So this is the dunya. So you're not gonna always have victory and triumph. Then the Sheikh said, it's not always like this. Allah, He alternates between his worshippers. So the Sahaba, the best of the Ummah, what happened to them when they were trusted? And they were, they were trusted and the trial put through trials. Allah said, Watilka, he said, Watilka, let's you get that. Watilka al-ayyam. We say وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامِ نُدَاوِلُهَا. So he said, if a wound and killing has touched you, be sure a similar wound and killing has touched the others. So are the days, good and not so good. We give to men by turns, that Allah may test those who believe, and that He may take martyrs from amongst you. And Allah likes not the zalimeen, the zalimun, the polytheists and the wrongdoers. So showing that people are tested on alternative, and it alternates. So a person should prepare, a servant should prepare himself that if he is tested, that this is not specific to him. Rather, people, the first of the companions preceded him. The awliya, the friends of Allah, preceded him in being tested. So he should prepare himself, and he should be patient, and he should wait for the relief from Allah. Obviously test, it came across those who preceded, and the aqibatu lil muttaqin. So and the blessed end is for the pious believers. Yeah. So, and he said, وَإِذَا أَذْنَبَ إِسْتَغْفَرَ. So the second, last part of the dua is that if he commits sin, he seeks forgiveness. أَمَّا الَّذِي إِذَا أَذْنَبَ لَا يَسْتَغْفِرْ وَيَسْتَزِيدْ. So as for the one who, if he sins, he doesn't seek forgiveness and he increases in that from his sins, then he is shaqi. Then he is what? He's wicked. Yeah? And we seek Allah's refuge in Allah, وَلِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ لَكِنَ الْعَبْدُ الْمُؤْمِنِ لَكِنَ الْعَبْدُ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنْ كُلَّ مَا صَدَرَ مِنْهُ ذَنْبْ بَادَرَ بِالتَّوْبَةِ. So every time, as a first servant, whenever a sin emanates from him, he hastens to make tawbah. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاهِشَ أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا لِذَنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرَ الذَّنُوبِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So Allah mentions in this ayah, we'll read this translation. So it is, وَالَّذِينَ, so mention that now here, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا. So here we said, and those who, when they have committed fahisa, illegal sexual intercourse, or wronged themselves with evil, remember Allah and ask forgiveness for their sins, and none can forgive sins but Allah, and do not persist in what wrong they have done, while they know for such their reward is forgiveness from their Lord, and gardens with rivers flowing underneath, where paradise wherein they shall abide therein forever. How excellent is the reward for the doers who do righteous deeds according to Allah's orders. So that's the full ayah. Then Allah mentions, "Inna tawba alallahi lilladhina ya'maluna as-su' bijahla thumma yatubuna min kareem." So we read the translation of that. Innama tawba. So then Allah, in Surah Nisa, Allah mentions, "Innama tawba الله إنما التوبة على الله للذين يعملون السوء بجهالة ثم يتوبون من قريب. So Allah accepts only the repentance of those who do evil in ignorance and foolishness and repent soon afterwards. So والجهالة ليس معناها عدم العلم. So ignorance, it doesn't mean here the absence of knowledge. لأن الجاهل لا يؤاخذ. So because the ignorant is not taken account for his ignorance. لكن الجهالة هنا هي ضد العلم. So here the Shaykh says, as for the ignorance here, then it's the opposite of hilm. Yeah, it's the absence of being patient. So that is the jahala here. So that is the ignorance here. That is the he's not forbearing, tolerant, and he's not patient. Yeah. So he doesn't have wisdom as well. So that's the community. And he's wanaqis al aqliya, and he is deficient in his hilm. Yeah. فَقُلُّ مَنْ عَصَى اللَّهَ فَهُوَ جَاهِلٌ بِمَعْنَى النَّاقِسِ الْحِلْمِ وَالنَّاقِسِ الْأَقْلِيَةِ وَالنَّاقِسِ الْإِنْسَانِيَةِ. So everyone who disobeys Allah, he's a jahil, he's jahil, yeah, he's ignorant, yeah, of the mean. With the meaning that he's deficient in his forbearance, in his patience, and his deficiency in his intelligence, and his deficient in his humanity. وَقَدْ يَكُونْ عَالِمًا لَكِنَّهُ جَاهِلٌ مِنْ نَاحِيَةِ أُخْرَى مِنْ نَاحِيَةِ أَنَّهُ لَيْسَ عِنْدَهُ حِلْمٌ وَلَا ثَبَاتٌ فِي الْأُمُورِ. So, and it may be that he's a someone who's knowledgeable, but he's jahil, ignorant. When it comes to the aspect or the angle or from another angle, from the angle that he doesn't have forbearance, and he doesn't have patience, and he doesn't have firmness in affairs. Then he said, "Thumma yatubuna min karib." From the ayah, Allah mentions that they repent soon. Yeah, they repent. Well, we go back to the ayah, which is the meaning is they. And repent soon afterwards. Yeah. So and they repent, meaning kullama adnabu istaghfaru. So whenever they commit sin, they seek forgiveness. Ma hunaka ahad ma'soom min adh-dhunub. There is no one who is free from committing sin. Walakin alhamdulillah anna Allah fataha bab at-tawbah. And we praise Allah, the Most High, that He has opened this door for repentance. فَعَلَى الْعَبْدِ إِذَا أَذْنَبَ أَنْ يُبَادَ بِالتَّوْبَةِ. So upon a person, on a slave, is to rush to make tawbah after he commits a sin. لَكِنْ إِذَا لَمْ يَتُوبْ وَلَمْ يَسْتَغْفِرْ فَهَذِهِ أَلَامَةُ الشَّقَاءِ. So then, but if a person doesn't seek forgiveness and he doesn't repent, then this is a sign of his misery, yeah? And he's being miserable, yeah? And wretched. وَقَدْ يَقْنِتُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَيَأْتِهِ شَيْطَانُ وَيَقُولُ لَهُ لَيْسَ لَكَ تَوْبَةٌ. And sometimes it may be the case that he despairs from the mercy of Allah, and Shaitan comes to him and says, "There's no tawbah for you. You can't make, you can't repent." نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. So هذه الأمور الثلاث. So these are the three affairs. So we know that we can make tawbah until we die. So it's upon us to make tawbah. So these are three affairs that if you are given, you are grateful. And if you are tested, you are patient. And if you are sinned, that you seek forgiveness. And this is the epitome of happiness. Man wuffiqa laha nala as-saada. So whoever is given success in this, he attains happiness. Wa man hurima minha aw min ba'diha fa innahu shaqi. So whoever is prohibited from this or from some of it, then indeed he is someone who is shaqi. He is he's the one who is you would say like wretched, or yeah, he's you know, miserable, yeah, and unhappy. So with that, inshallah, let's see, we'll finish. I will continue next lesson. Barakallahu feekum, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu alayk.